Lucy realized she was back home when the sounds of the forest gave way to a familiar silence. Though the songs that the townsfolk have always been deaf to still resonated in her head. And like a disease that sneaks in, spreads and grows stronger, maybe their hearing wasn't the only sense being clouded. It seems incredible that a single small child learnt in a second more than an entire town did in a lifetime. But it was neither protection nor the idea of freedom that Lucy really wanted. It was to wake up those who once only saw us and them. With no more dualities, all we had left was emptiness. An emptiness full of hope for what it could turn into. Definitely something precious and fragile to care for faithfully, that finally, after all this time, could really be a future. Lucy realized she was back home when the sounds of the forest gave way to a familiar silence. Though the songs that the townsfolk have always been deaf to still resonated in her head. And like a disease that sneaks in, spreads and grows stronger, maybe their hearing wasn't the only sense being clouded. The notes rose into the air as clear as they'd ever been. Lucy, though, didn't know that her voice could no longer reach them. You would think it impossible to understand what Lucy felt that night, but the truth is that we understand. We do know what it means to leave behind the place we come from and our loved ones to face the unknown. But deep within, we knew it was the right thing to do. So let these people, all their husks, go on with their half-lived lives. Here in the forest, we will keep singing. Those they call monsters.
Can you hear, listen?
Deep in her heart, Lucy knew someone would remember her voice. Someone who, although blinded by fear, would still hold on to the privilege of doubt. Someone with nothing to lose, who would look below the surface. We do not believe in coincidences, but in choices. To remember or to forget, to leave or to stay. Some choices will always haunt us, making us wonder who we could have become instead. We can only hope that one day we won't feel the need to look back. Lucy realized she was back home when the sounds of the forest gave way to a familiar silence. though the songs that the townsfolk have always been deaf to still resonated in her head. And like a disease that sneaks in, spreads and grows stronger, maybe their hearing wasn't the only sense being clouded. Her voice, a whisper against the rage of the townsfolk, broke through the gaze of the children who still believed. They are the ones who cracked the wall, and a breach opened up for those who, deep within, didn't want to lose anyone else. And yet, how could it be enough? How could a single note be heard in that willful silence? Those two worlds, always apart, could not change in a single night. No bridge could ever cover such a distance. We were all sure of it. Everyone but one child. A child who had seen and would never forget. Chose to teach all who'd listen that every rule can always be rewritten. Since then, as the wind whispers through the trees, hidden by the shadows of an endless forest, we hear those white songs. And we listen, watching over those who chose to believe in our future.
I sing my song so you